from Pastor Steve again. Philippians chapter 1, 28 through 30. He says, don't be intimidated by your opponents. This is a sign for their destruction, for your salvation, a sign from God. For it has been granted, verse 29, it has been granted to you not only to believe in Christ, but to suffer for him, since you're encountering the same conflict that you saw in me and now here that I'm facing. In times of hard times and conflict, which are coming, we're told to fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. Jesus said, I'll never leave you or forsake you. He tells us also, stand fast in the faith. These are all things that we are having to learn to do now, so that when the hard times come, we will not back off. Remember, Daniel was forced to decide whether he'd continue praying as he always had done. Now, he didn't wait till the edict went out and then start praying. He prayed always and just continued and put up with whatever God had brought his way. I get an email devotion called Standing Strong in the Storm, and it's about persecuted people around the world. In Yemen, during their hard times right now, Christians are reaching out to others in spite of their suffering. In Kenya, 148 students slain because they were Christ followers. April 14th was the anniversary of the Boko Haram's capture of those 275 Nigerian girls. Hard times, hard times. One pastor who was incarcerated in China off and on for 23 years said, listen to this. He said, I was pushed into a cell, but you have to push yourself into one. You have no time to know God. You need to build yourself a cell so you can do for yourself what persecution did for me. Simplify your life and know God. Wow, God's grace is sufficient. Take time, get in your cell today and know God. Bring every thought captive to Christ. Spend time alone with God, asking the hard questions. Then go to his revealed word for the answers. And then you and I both can echo God's son's prayer in the garden, not my will, but thy will be done. That's something to think about, Pastor Steve.